The fusion reaction, one of the impressive scientific feats of the 21st century.
So the work at the Lawrence Livermore Lab involved 192 lasers in a building the size of 3 football fields. And it holds the promise of clean, abundant energy.
News 19 Chief Investigative Reporter Brian Lawson looked into this today and joins us now in the studio. Brian, what can you tell us?
Well, short answer is it's pretty remarkable. I spoke to Dr. Jason Casabri, who is a professor at UAH who's worked on fusion projects for the past 20 years. There's fusion work going on at UAH related to propulsion and other systems work that he said is a cousin to the work in California. It's exciting.
If you want to build a reactor for fusion in which you produce electricity for the grid, or if you want to have a propulsion system, you need the energy released to be greater than the energy invested.
The experiment used 192 lasers shooting at a very small target in order
to exceed the energy that's been deposited into the sphere by fusion reactions. And that's been achieved, and that's what their big milestone is, and that's what we're celebrating today.
Professor Casabri said researchers have been working publicly on fusion since 1958. There were questions about if it could work. Now the possibilities are amazing.
If we can learn to use deuterium from the world's water supply, it provides a virtually inexhaustible amount of fuel for producing electricity.
It could fuel the future of space travel.
As we advance beyond Artemis to human exploration of Mars and beyond, we need advanced propulsion to get humans to destinations much more quickly. And fusion would be one of the technologies that would cut that trip time down by about a factor of 3.
It could also democratize countries' access to energy, given that the deuterium isotope is widely available in water.
Not in just certain mines in certain countries, it's everywhere. And so from that standpoint, the fuel is abundantly available wherever there's water. And so it would greatly help even out the playing field and give everybody a shot at abundant, clean energy.
Now, Dr. Casabri said the results mean the hard part is done and the psychological barrier that has been there on fusion has been lifted. Now he says the challenge is making it better and more practical and converting that energy to electricity.